Your Eye on Annapolis Daily News Brief keeps you informed about what's happening in Annapolis, Anne Arundel County, and Maryland. Local news, local sports, local events, local opinion, and of course, local weather. Your Eye on Annapolis Daily News Brief starts now.
Good morning. It's Monday, December 20th, 2021. This is John Frenay, and this is your Eye on Annapolis Daily News Brief. All right, the final stretch for the holidays, and I do have some wrapping to do this week. But before we get into that, some quick housekeeping notes. We're taking a few days off of the DNB over the holidays, so you're going to have to go to ionannapolis.net for all of the scoop and all of your news. We will not have an episode on Friday the 24th or Monday the 27th or Friday the 31st or Monday the 3rd. Well, it is Monday, and there is a ton of news, so let's get into it, shall we? Boy, Alex Mann of the Baltimore Sun and Lily Price of the Capitol really broke a giant story over the weekend. Back in June, the Annapolis police and EMS responders restrained a patient who was on some sort of a drug. However, they restrained him face down and ultimately he died. Now, in September, the medical examiner ruled his death a homicide, but for some reason it was not made public until just now, and the family was not even notified. The state's attorney has confirmed that there is now an investigation underway, and the Capitol article said that the type of restraint used was against policy. I have a feeling this is going to become a huge story as we learn more about what happened and why everything was so delayed. And in another case of delayed reporting from the Annapolis Police Department, they released this December 1st incident on December 17th. Back on December 1st, officers were near Copeland Street when they saw an SUV drive away at a high rate of speed. They tried to stop it, but it didn't stop for them, and for some reason they just didn't pursue it. The only description they provided was that it was a, quote, dark-colored SUV, unquote. At about the same time as the SUV was fleeing, they received calls about shots being fired in that area where the SUV had fled from. They found several vehicles and apartments riddled with gunfire and are unaware of any injuries. Aside from the delay in the reporting, I have to ask how a fleeing SUV can just get away that simply, and how come the pursuing officers do not have any more of a description other than a, quote, dark-colored SUV? I realize it was at 6:30 p.m. at night, so it was dark, but still, lots of things that are making me go, And over at the Anne Arundel County Police Department, they are looking for help in finding a dark-colored pickup truck that hit a pedestrian and fled the scene on December 16th. Police believe it to be a 2009 to 2014 Ford F-150, which was identified by taillights and headlight patterns captured in the video. The pedestrian is identified as a 54-year-old male with no fixed address, and he does remain in critical condition. This happened on Route 2 at Ritchie Highway near Baltimore and Annapolis Boulevard, right there by the courthouse, at 6 p.m. on the 16th. And if anybody has any information, 410-222-4700 is the number to call. A little bit of COVID news. Hospitalizations are still on the rise here in Maryland with 1,257 people hospitalized. However, because we are still dealing with a cyber attack, we don't really know how many cases, daily deaths, etc. And I'm not sure why no one is screaming about this as the Omicron variant gets more and more severe. Governor Hogan was on Fox News Sunday and said despite the rise in COVID and oncoming surge, he is not planning any lockdown measures. As a term-limited Republican in a Democratic state, I think he's going to let the counties handle that and take the heat as he slides a little bit closer to Trumpville to hopefully engage that slice of the Republican Party as he toys with a presidential run. Hey, if you need a distraction today, head on over to ionannapolis.net and check out Glenn Miller's photos from the 14th annual Santa Speedo Run. Always a great laugh. As I mentioned last week, it was a toy drive, and this year, instead of supporting local families, the toys and books were loaded onto a truck that afternoon and shipped to Bremen, Kentucky, population 350, which was essentially wiped off of the map with the tornadoes the other weekend. The kids of Bremen will have some gifts this year, courtesy of the Annapolis Santa Speedo Run. But Crosby Marketing is doing some good right here in our own backyard. They were a generous supporter of the Anne Arundel County Food Bank earlier this year, and now they have doubled down. They will match all donations between now and the end of the year up to $25,000. And believe me, that buys a lot of food for hungry families. So if you can contribute $10, $20, or whatever amount, it will be doubled by Crosby Marketing. You want to head to aafoodbank.org/give. That's simple enough. Again, aafoodbank.org/give, and you can get in on this match. And as we start to wrap up, I hope you caught the local business spotlight with Michelle Davey from Davey Dance Academy in Cape. Next Saturday, we have Shay Cook from Crusaders for Change. And along with our days off for the Daily News Brief, we're also going to take a few weekends off on the local business spotlights to record a few more and get some more into the can, as they say. If you do know any businesses, please let me know. I will reach out to them and get them scheduled. And finally, remember my Holiday Lights program. Well, it will be releasing a little bit later today. I have the map almost complete, so you want to check out ionanapolis.net for that one. And if you know of some awesome holiday lights in the county, just let me know the address. I will add it to the map as we go along. My email address is info@ionanapolis.net. All right, that's it for the news. But first, a quick thank you to our sponsors for today's Daily News Brief: Solar Energy Services, the Christy Neidhart team of Northrop Realty, a Long & Foster company, and Hospice of the Chesapeake. All righty, it is Monday, and Ann Alsina from Covington Alsina is here with your Monday Money Report. And as always, George Young from DCMDVA Weather is here with your locally forecast weather. All that coming up in just a bit.
Another moving moment from Christy Neidhart of the Christy Neidhart team from Northrop Realty, a Long & Foster company.
I always look forward to November as I think of it as a whole month to focus on gratitude. I am incredibly grateful to our past and current clients who've entrusted us with the sale of one of their largest assets, their homes. Over the past 2 years, that's nearly 200 individuals and families who we've had the privilege to serve. I'm grateful that we get to be a part of their lives when their families grow, grateful to be trusted when a loved one is lost or becomes ill, grateful to be a part of helping someone become a homeowner for the very first time, and grateful to be a part of someone's moving onto the water or finding a second home retreat. I'd like to take this opportunity to challenge you to think of the people in your life that you are grateful for: friends, family, coworkers, service providers, and so many others. Reach out and let them know. And if we can help you with a move in the future, give us a call.
That's another moving moment from Christy Neidhart. To get in touch, call 410-599-1370 or visit kn-team.com. That's kn-team.com.
When you live near Annapolis, you know how fickle the weather can be. So you need a truly local forecast that's accurate and reliable. Forecast right here in Annapolis. DCMDVA Weather is not just for today, but for the rest of the week and the weekend too. Now here's George Young of DCMDVA Weather with the weather outlook for today and beyond.
Hey everyone, this is George with DCMDVA Weather, and this is your Eye on Annapolis forecast for Monday, December 20th. A bit of a cool, cloudy, and slightly wet weekend for the Annapolis region, but the week ahead should be quite the opposite with tons of sun and dry skies. Look for sunny but cool conditions today in the low to mid 40s, followed by mixed skies with plenty of clouds tomorrow with highs near 50 degrees, with sun then returning each day Wednesday through the weekend, with highs 50 to 55 on Wednesday, 43 to 49 or so on Thursday, and near 50 again on Friday, ahead of a very nice and warm Christmas Saturday with sunny skies and highs maybe 60 plus degrees for many across the Mid-Atlantic region. Okay, that's it for today. This is George Young of DCMDVA Weather. Make it a great day out there. Stay healthy and be safe. And be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter and use our website each day at dcmdvaweather.info as you wrap up your shopping this week. And as always, be sure to download our app on all of your devices by searching for DCMDVA Weather from the Apple or Google App Stores so you can always stay weather informed.
Hello, energy consumers. This is Rick Peters, president of Solar Energy Services, with your Clean Energy Minute. Does your home experience power outages? Or maybe you're concerned about energy resilience in general? If so, that's another great reason to consider clean, quiet solar-powered energy with battery backup. You may have heard residential solar adoption has rapidly increased during the pandemic for multiple reasons, and many homeowners, like yourself, are adding battery backup and electric vehicle charging to their solar projects. And with Maryland's residential energy storage income tax credit, along with the federal tax credit for batteries when paired with solar, the economics are quite compelling, and that secure feeling is even better. So whether you're looking for clean energy, energy resilience, or overall peace of mind with solar energy, we can help. To schedule a free solar design, call us today at 410-923-6090 or on the web at solarsaves.net. But hurry, sunshine's a-wasting.
Sunshine, sunshine. Nothing else can make me feel so fine.
You work hard for your money. Is your money working hard for you? Managing and investing, it can be confusing. Ann Alsina, a financial planner from Covington Alsina, has been helping people make sense of it all for over 17 years. Are you ready? Now here's your Monday Money Report.
This is Ann Alsina of Covington Alsina with your Monday Money Report. Last week was a roller coaster as the markets reacted before the Fed met on Wednesday and then again after the meeting. Down, up, and down again. The Federal Reserve announced they will taper bond purchases at a faster rate, reducing each month's purchases by about $30 billion. This puts them on track to stop buying bonds in February. At that point, they would consider raising interest rates. Which means what, exactly? Depending on the state of the economy, defined by inflation and unemployment, the Fed may raise rates as many as three times in 2022. This contracts the monetary supply as it costs more to borrow funds. But none of that is bad for stocks. While there is no crystal ball, 2022 should still be a positive year for the market. Maybe not the 25% we're up this year, but still growing. And as Florida's head coach, Billy Napier, quoted from Young Jeezy, "Scared money don't make money. If you have a plan, stick to it. And if you don't have a plan, the new year is a great time to develop one." This is our last Monday Money Report of the year, and we have a laundry list of action items for you. If you're looking for tax deductions, remember your favorite nonprofits. Even if you don't itemize, you're allowed a $300 deduction for charitable donations on top of the standard deduction. That's $600 for married couples. You have until the end of the year for Roth conversions as well, protecting all the future growth in your Roth account from future taxation for your lifetime plus 10 years. If you really have charitable intent, we can pair a Roth conversion with a charitable donation. Don't forget to take any required minimum distributions from your retirement accounts if you're 72 or older, or if you've inherited an IRA. At Covington Alsina, tax loss harvesting is a daily activity. But if you haven't kept on top of that throughout the year, take some time to check for losses in your portfolio and evaluate those positions. It might be a good time to sell and offset some of your gains. Finally, if you have young adults coming home for the holidays, this is a great time to make sure they have a power of attorney and medical directive in place. We have the Maryland state forms here and are happy to notarize them for you. Be sure to check out our website at CovingtonAlsina.com as well as our Facebook page. Securities offered through LPL Financial, member FINRA SIPC. Investment advice offered through Great Valley Advisor Group, or registered investment advisor. Covington Alsina and Great Valley Advisor Group are separate entities from LPL Financial. All performance references are historical and is no guarantee of future results. All indices are unmanaged and may not be invested into directly. This information is not intended to be a substitute for specific individualized tax advice. We suggest that you discuss your specific tax issues with a qualified tax advisor. The opinions voiced in this show are for general information only and are not intended to provide specific advice or recommendations for any individual. To determine which strategies or investments may be appropriate for you, contact the appropriate qualified professional prior to making a decision. And if you don't have a financial advisor, come talk to us. This is Ann Alsina with Covington Alsina.
Hello, Sean Lynch here from the team at Galway Bay to tell you about our very own Irish eggnog. This wonderful creamy drink is a handcrafted traditional style eggnog distilled and bottled in Ireland. It's made from an old Irish recipe with a blend of alcohol, spices and Irish cream that is completely unique and has now become an Annapolis tradition. When you visit one of our local restaurants here, either at Galway Bay in historic downtown Annapolis, Killarney House in Davidsonville, or Brian Brew in Severna Park, please mention this ad to your server or bartender to get a complimentary taste. Share this delicious concoction with friends and family for a thoughtful and unique holiday gift. Available by the bottle, case and half case at all three locations. Or go to our website at galwaybaymd.com for further information.
Also available at Pirate's Cove Restaurant and Dock Bar in Galesville.
You've been listening to the Eye on Annapolis Daily News Brief. Tell your friends and colleagues, this is the podcast where you can keep up on the latest with what's going on in Annapolis and Anne Arundel County. And don't forget about our website, ionannapolis.net, where you can find even more information. And make sure you follow us on Facebook at All Annapolis and on Twitter at IonAnnapolis. This Daily News Brief podcast comes to you every Monday through Friday at 6 a.m.